the channel. In the previous video of the series, we saw how we can make use of sets and maps to efficiently retrieve the intersection of two given arrays. And as a quick refresher, we tackled two aspects of this problem, retrieving the unique intersection and the actual intersection of two given arrays. The unique intersection can be retrieved efficiently by transforming one of the arrays to a set, then looping over the second array, all while checking in constant time if its elements appear in the set we created. If they do, we add them to our result and return it when we are done. The actual intersection, if you recall, can be retrieved in a similar manner. What we did was transform the first given array to a map representing the elements in this array alongside their frequencies. Then we looped over the elements of the second array and checked if its elements appear among the keys of the map we created, while taking into consideration the frequency of their appearance. If they do, we add them to our result and return it once our loop ends. Okay, this was done and thoroughly explained in the last video of the series. Today we are going to tackle two additional aspects to this problem, which will allow us to dive deeper in the concepts we previously explained and put our problem-solving skills to the test. So, if you were asked to solve this problem in an interview, the first follow-up question may be, what if the given array is already sorted? Is there a way to further optimize this algorithm? You see, the optimization we are talking about here is not related to time, because each element must be checked at least once in order to figure out the intersection. So, by optimization, the interviewer means space. Take a look at both previous solutions we wrote. Notice how in addition to the result set or result list we are returning to the user, we created a set or a map to store the elements of the first array. And this takes extra space allocation, in this case a space of size n, making our space complexity O of n. Now, the follow-up question suggests that the arrays are sorted, but how will sorting these arrays help us solve this problem in constant space, or in other terms, without using extra space? Say we have these two sorted arrays. We know for a fact that the first element of each array is the smallest element stored inside each one. Hence, we are faced with two options only. Either they are equal, meaning the element can be added to the resulting intersection, or one is bigger than the other, meaning the smaller element has no chance, zero, to be part of the intersection, whereas the bigger element may still have a chance to appear in the upcoming elements of the array, right? All we have to do is keep searching for it. With that said, we can deduce the following algorithm, which uses two pointers, one for each of the arrays we have. These pointers will keep on looping over the elements of the arrays simultaneously, and if two elements are equal, we add that element to the resulting intersection and increment both pointers. If not, we increment only the one pointing to the smaller value element. To implement this, all you have to do is create two indices, one for each array, then while none of these indices has reached the end of its corresponding array yet, we check if the values sitting at these indices are equal. If yes, we add the value to the resulting intersection and increment both of these indices. If they are not equal, we check which value is the smaller one and we increment that index accordingly. Finally, after our loop ends, we return with the resulting array. Notice how if one of these arrays contains more elements than the second, we don't need to write a buffer while loop like the one you see, because the moment we exited the while loop we wrote, we knew that all the remaining elements in the first array are bigger in value than the last element stored in the second array, meaning there is no way to have an intersection from this point forward. Additionally, this solution can be used to return the actual and unique intersections. The one you see right now returns the actual intersection, and if you want to return the unique intersection, all you have to do is replace this list with a set, and that's it. Before tackling the second aspect of this problem, I want to tell you that if you decided to test this solution on LeetCode, you'll need to sort the arrays manually before writing the code we wrote, as here we are assuming that the given arrays are sorted. Okay, the next follow-up questions the interviewer might ask you is, considering these arrays are still sorted, what if the first array's size is much bigger, way bigger than the second one? How can we optimize this algorithm further to find the set of unique intersections? You may ask me here, but what's the correlation between the difference in size and performance? Well, consider we have these two arrays. The first one contains millions of sorted elements, and the second one only three elements. If we were to use the algorithm we just wrote, we'll have to traverse millions of elements before reaching these three elements stored in the first array, which actually represent the intersection with the second array, as you can see. So how do we make our algorithm more efficient given this constraint? Well, there are tons of approaches to tackle such questions, but our answer requires us to recall one of our previous videos, the binary search one. You see, given that the arrays are sorted, we know that given an element, we can check if that element exists in any sorted array in a logarithmic complexity with the help of binary search. And that's what we'll do. We will loop over the unique set of elements of the second array, and for each one, we will invoke the binary search algorithm to check if that element exists in the first array. This will return the set of unique intersections between the two given arrays. The complexity of this algorithm is O of m log n, m being the size of the second array and n the size of the first one. And given that m is way smaller than n, this algorithm will prove to be more efficient than the one running at O of n. Now, this particular solution cannot be used to retrieve the actual intersection. So how do we do that? You know what? I'll leave this one to you. So leave me your thoughts and solutions down below. Also, do not forget to mention the topics/problems you'd like us to tackle, analyze, and see next in this series. So, that's it for this video. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.